Congratulations, what a fantastic fight. Did you feel you'd done enough when the final bell rang?
On the basis of what Gav told me, sometimes I can't remember and take in what's actually going on, but I did know I landed a lot of shots. I could feel it on my hands, so I knew I was landing the shots, and especially with the knockdown at the beginning, it did give me a lot of confidence as well.
Talk us through that knockdown. It was a hell of a way to start the fight. It looked as if, maybe was it an off-balance issue, or was it just a well-timed shot in the end?
It was a well-timed shot. It must have been, because she did get down. But yeah, Gav said it was off a hook. I didn't know what had happened. I was like, oh, she's on the floor. So yeah, I was happy with that, especially in the first round. I thought, oh, I'm making a statement from the very off, really, about what I can do and that I am strong. I'm not just a lanky, awkward fighter, that I have got some power as well.
We know she'd have to be trying to close the distance, obviously, with the size difference. Yeah. You seemed to be catching her as she was coming in. Yeah. Was that always the game plan?
Yeah. Yeah, I think she was expecting me to literally like kind of run at her. So I was like, OK, I'm going to stand some ground in the middle, and then when she comes on to me, you know, land my shots, and that's what I could feel myself doing, so that was my aim to do.
She said she was going to shock people with her power tonight. She did land some big shots. Can you just talk us through those? Were you ever hurt in the fight?
Yeah, respectfully, she did land some shots, and she did daze me a few times, so but that's fine. I'm in it for a good fight. I wanted a respectable and tough opponent, and that's what I got. So I'm happy with the outcome, really, and yeah, I'm pleased.
What an amazing statement you've made on the biggest of stages, live on Sky Sports and DAZN as well. You've been so calm right throughout the build-up. Did you always truly believe that this would be your night?
Yeah, for me, this has been like a 21st century fairy tale for me. I'm not chasing a Prince Charming or whatever. I'm chasing a dream. And for me, I've met fantastic people. I've been whisked away from my normal life and to this crazy bubble. And I've absolutely loved it. And I haven't stopped smiling ear to ear all week. And I just wanted this to be my night now.
We talked about the odds tumbling with the bookmakers. Yeah. You started as a massive underdog and almost came into the fight even money. What do you feel it was about the people at home, the punters, having faith in you and backing you to win this fight?
I've been absolutely overwhelmed by the amount of support that I've had, from messages, people putting their money where their mouth is and believing in me. Sorry, I'm so emotional. So I'm just being really overwhelmed.
Have you got a message for those watching back home?
Sorry.
No, take your time. I mean, you've just achieved an amazing feat there. So just take your time.
Thank you. Just thank you. I really appreciate it.
When you think about what you've been doing with your boxing, balancing that with your social work, I think you've probably inspired a lot of people tonight. And you've sort of been a showcase of what hard work and dedication can get you.
Yeah, it's hard. It's really hard. But I've done it, and I'm just proud of myself. I'm proud of myself, what I do. Try and stop it. I'm proud of myself on a day-to-day basis, and I've just achieved my dream.
And I think this is probably just the beginning for you now. With a win like that on a stage like this, I can't imagine that promotional deals and contracts are going to be too far away from you now.
I hope so, I really do.
This is maybe the time that Rachel Ball, the social worker, full-time becomes Rachel Ball, the boxer.
I'd love that. And I've always got social work to fall back on, and I'll always be passionate about it.
A word on Shannon Courtenay. You've suffered yourself a setback. She'll be back from this, won't she?
Yeah. You know what? It is hard. And, it was hard. And I remember going back to my hotel. That's my first loss, and I cried. And, I hope she comes back from it. I hope she just pulls herself up and think, yeah, let's go for it again, because let's face it, there's no other awkward, lanky, tall person like me, so why not? I always encourage all women to go as far as they can, and of course, even though Shannon's my opponent, I wish her all the best for their future as well.
We've seen some brilliant fights recently with the likes of Harper Jonas last week. Again, an incredible advert for women's boxing tonight.
Yeah, it is. I hope everyone really enjoyed it, and I hope everyone gets behind us. And if you do see a local girl who's just starting out, I really want you to go and just pull some money out your pocket and go and buy a ticket off them. That's the best thing that you can do. And give them a like on social media, send them your support, because it really does mean the world, and it will really, really push us even further if just that bit of support.
Rachel, huge congratulations. You're an inspiration.
Thank you.
Very well done.
Thank you.